Welcome to the SOTI video series. My name is Richard, a senior principal instructor within SOTI's global training team. And in this video, we'll work through the configuration of Apple push notification services with SOTI MobiControl. We'll go to the SOTI MobiControl hamburger menu, go down to global settings and select Apple and Apple push notification service. From there, I can create my configuration. I'll click on create. And the first thing I'll do is sign in to the Apple push certificates portal. Now this would be a company Apple ID, and if you're using Apple Business Manager, which we'll refer to in a separate video, this can be the same Apple ID as used for Apple Business Manager. Now you can see I've done this process a couple of times before, but in our case, we'll be selecting the Create a Certificate option in green at the top. Now the first thing I'm going to need to do is upload a vendor signed certificate sign-in request. Where can we get this from? Well, it's directly from the SOTI MobiControl console and that configuration window we've already seen. I'll download my certificate sign-in request from here. And once downloaded to my local machine, I'll choose File and select the sign-in request. I'll click Upload. And I'll have a confirmation message that says you have successfully created a new push certificate with the following information, with an expiry date. Now, in terms of the expiry date, it's very important that we renew the certificate before the expiry date. If we go past the expiry date and the certificate hasn't been renewed, any Apple device enrolled in SOTI MobiControl will need to be re-enrolled from fresh. Now, Apple provide notifications via email that the expiry date is coming up, along with notifications on the SOTI MobiControl console. We'll see how to renew the certificate shortly. But for now, I'll select download. I'll move back to the SOTI MobiControl console. And now that I've downloaded the certificate, I'll browse file and I'll add in our new certificate into SOTI MobiControl. Now that I've got the certificate from the Apple portal uploaded, finally, I'll just add the Apple ID that I used to create the certificate and then click save. The Apple ID that we used to create the certificate is very beneficial because we can easily refer back to which particular account and which particular certificate we used in order to help us with a renewal in a year's time. Our configuration and our connection to Apple push notification service is now enabled. We can test this. We're getting a response of active and successful. We can see that there is a topic string and a serial number, which is helpful for identification and also for the renewal process that we'll look at shortly. Also, we can see when this is added and the all important expiry date. And once again, if we go past the expiry date, the devices will need to be re-enrolled. So it's very important that we renew before that date comes up. Thank you for joining us for this video where we have configured Apple push notification services with SOTI MobiControl. Join us for the next section where we'll talk about the importance of renewing APNS certificates. For further tutorials, visit and subscribe to the SOTI YouTube channel, and for more information about the SOTI Watt platform, visit soti.net.